The second example is adapted from problem 37 at the end of chapter 11. Agnes Hammer is a senior majoring in management science. She's curious about what starting salary offers she might receive. There are 140 seniors in the graduating class for her major, and more than half have received job offers. She asked 12 of her classmates at random what their annual starting salary offers were, and she received the following responses. Assume that the starting salaries are normally disputed. Please answer the following 5 questions. A. Compute the mean and standard deviation for this data. B. Determine the probability that Agnes will receive a salary offer of less than $50,000. C. What is the probability that Agnes will receive a salary offer between $45,000 and $55,000? D. What offer will make Agnes the bottom 20% in starting salary of all MS majors? And E. What offer will make Agnes the top 1% in starting salary of all management science majors? Now, let me launch my Excel. As you can see, I have already prepared all the information we need, and we just need to go ahead and find the answers. First of all, in question A, let's find the mean and standard deviation of this data. To find the mean, it's pretty straightforward. We can use the Excel function average. So we find the average of all those 12 salary numbers. And this is the mean of all the salaries. Next, let's go ahead and find the sample standard deviation, and we can use an Excel function called stdev.s. S means this is a sample, not a population. We want standard deviation of all those 12 numbers. Hit return, and we get the sample standard deviation is about 3,996. Now let's turn to question B. We would like to determine the probability that Agnes will receive a salary offer of less than $50,000. The threshold value will be 50,000. And we want to find the probability her offer will be less than this amount. It's going to be norm.dist, threshold value 50,000, mean standard deviation, and this is a cumulative distribution function. Hit return. We get a probability of 44.86%. In question C, we would like to find the probability that Agnes will receive an offer between $45,000 and $55,000. And this probability will be equal to norm.dist upper bound mean standard deviation and cumulative distribution. Once again, recall that this gives us the probability that she will receive an offer less than $55,000. And he has to subtract the probability that she receives an offer of less than $45,000. Return. And this probability turns out to be 78.53%. Now let's look at question D. What offer will make Agnes the bottom 20% in starting salary of all management science majors? It is the same as asking for 20th percentile. To get that, we're going to use norm.inverse probability 0.2 or 20%, mean standard deviation, and we get an amount of about $47,000. That is to say, if Agnes receives an offer of $47,153, that will put her at the bottom 20% in starting salary of all management science majors. In the end, let's look at question E. What salary offer will make Agnes the top 1% in starting salary of all management science majors? This is the same as asking for 99th percentile. To find that, we're going to do the same thing. Norm.inverse probability 99%, mean standard deviation, and we get amount of 59,814. That is, if Agnes receives an offer of $59,814, that put her in the top 1% in starting salary of all management science majors.